You're a strange sort of girl. You haven't yet told me your name.
Oh, it's the same name. You would like
it. Of course I would. Whatever you are called, it's the most beautiful name in the world. And whatever your name is, I love you. And I will always love you. You're not saying anything. I just told you I love you, and you're not saying anything.
I'm afraid to. I'm afraid I might wake up.
Are you sure you're asleep?
Yeah.
Are you feeling that I'm not listening? A girl I never saw before comes down to the last day. My whole life has changed. Suddenly, I'm in a different world. I'm deeply in love, and yet, I do not know why I'm in love. Do you?
No, I don't.
Do you know why I'm in love? What did you think I
was? I thought you were. Well, you are not anymore.
Oh, do you? I mean, are you?
Oh, yes.
And do you know why?
No, there is no one.
I always want to know why I do anything or why I feel anything. So I ask myself, why do you, a stranger, are suddenly the only girl I can love? And you're the only one of your kind. Why? Why is the sound of your voice the sweetest sound in the world? And why is the color of your hair the only color that most of us see? Why would I rather hold you in my arms than do anything else in the world?
Because of me.
This is.
This is. Because it's the way you feel.
Why do I feel? What makes you so miraculous?
Your imagination.
And what makes my imagination so miraculous?
Oh, I love you because of you. trying to find out
I will try everything. I will search every inch of the kingdom for the honor of this slipper.
That's what happens. Well, I would.
See that the slipper is tried on every young girl, no matter how unlikely she looks. You are to keep trying until you find the one that fits. Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
Find that girl.
I will just go speak with the chief of my secret service.
Suppose we don't find her.
Must
not. Before last night, he knew nothing about her. He knew nothing about her now except that she danced prettily and she looked pretty.
I know. She is the loveliest thing on earth. And I'll never be happy without her.
Why do you think that?
I don't know, Mother. And I don't expect you to understand.
But I do understand, Chris. I know it doesn't take long to feel the way you do, Princess Girl. But there is one fact I want you to face. You may never see her. I don't want you to waste your life on a dream. I want you to be in love with the real world.
She is real.
She was real last night. If she doesn't come back, she may never be real again, will she? Chris, be honest with yourself. Does your future happiness really depend on your finding her, or are you telling yourself that? Don't be angry with me. Think over what I'm saying. Ask yourself if this is not just an illusion, an infatuation with something that doesn't exist at all.
You're out there somewhere. I don't know where. You said last night that you thought we were dreaming. Maybe you were right. Maybe my mother's right. How can I know? How can one ever know?
Here.
We have instructed triumph to throw on everyone.
There would be no use trying on her. Try upstairs. How dare you? Come poking your nose into my business. I thought this was the princess's business. He's the one trying to find a mixed girl, isn't he?
But Cinderella.
Well, she's a girl.
There is no one there.
No one there? Isn't that just like Cinderella? The laundry is even finished.
Or the floor.
So much better.